people would say that we reminded them of the Nichols Brothers, and that we would be the next Nichols Brothers. And so I hadn't seen them yet, but I was aware of them. I think in my little mind, I figured they must be great, because I thought we were pretty good, and I figured they must be great. And I thought that that was going to be, we were going to be the next Nichols Brothers, until I saw them. And then when I saw them, I realized that nobody was going to be the next Nichols Brothers. Least of all, my brother and I. When people come to me, and tell me, isn't Michael Jackson the greatest? I said, what? What are you talking about? Did you see Tap on His Toes? What are you talking about? Dr. Louie did that. The Nichols Brothers did that. Don't come to me and tell me something that's going to make me become truly angry, because you don't do your history, especially your black history, and don't know where that greatness comes from. That comes from those people who came before us. And the Michael Jackson, Janet Jackson, all these dancers that are supposed to be dancers now, don't come close to the Nichols Brothers. People's tables, you know, people are sitting at tables, and they get on the stairs, and they're like, bah. I mean, it's great. That's great. The dance hasn't even started yet. So now, once they start the dance, they go into it. It's very jazzy. I remember, you know, it's like, it's very jazzy, and they're very relaxed. They're just dancing. Nice and easy, and they're just setting the thing up. That they're going to now dance. And then when they go over to where the bandstand is, they move over to the bandstand, and as soon as they jump up there, I mean, now they're painting another picture. You know, I think the music at that point was, bye, and they're going, now we're building. And now they jump off of that, and that's the first time they jump into splits. And now we haven't even warmed up yet, but they jump off that thing into splits and come up. Now they go up these stairs up on a landing there. And at that point, I thought that this is where the number's going to end. Because it was pretty, they've been there for a while. Then they jump on a piano top. And at that point in the number, I think even now, just to show that, where they jump on the piano top, it's one of the most powerful, it's real power tap dancing. Because they jump on the piano top, and they do something like, and then, after that, then they jump off the piano. Now we're jumping from another higher level. Now it's not just the piano, now it's off the piano, they jump into splits. So now, they move along, they move out of there, and they move into this area where in the back of them is this big thing. And you know, at that point, I thought maybe my heart might burst. Even now, when I see them go in front of that thing, I think to myself, you know, what are they going to do? the way they would perform, and the way they would...
Thank you.
fall and the way going to fall, and the way they're project themselves was pure class. That's all it was.
Fox's All Black Musical Stormy Weather featured Lena Horne, Bill Robinson, Fats Waller, and Tab Calloway. But it was the Nicholas Brothers who stole the movie with a dance number Fred Astaire once called the greatest ever put on film.
I think the Stormy Weather number is like Shakespeare. They begin like champions, doing some very interesting tap steps. And they jump up on the orchestra stand. To the music and then they dance right inside the music. Play with us, they do three or four splits, they go back and come up without using their hands. So when they head up on the right side of the staircase, it's beautiful. It's so beautiful. I mean, every time they land, that could be a beautiful picture. And then, they come down. We never realized it, but we could picture in our minds what we were really supposed to do. And we start doing it. One step right after the other, over each other's head. And Nick Castle, our dance director, said, "Cut. That's it. You cannot get it any better." And I said,